Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, on this channel we also have a series in which we daily discuss important editorials or articles or opinions that appear in your Indian Express newspaper. Basically we daily discuss all those important articles that are important from your exam point of view. So today is 24 October, so let's see what are the articles that are today that are here that we will discuss. So before starting the discussion friends, I received feedback from some students that sir, please also start covering explained page of Indian Express. So first thing I want to tell you friends is that Indian Express, as is clear by its name, the explained page. So it is very simple in language, so it hardly needs any explanation, because the language is kept easy and the topic is covered in a way that a reader can read it and can understand it. So so that he or she can comprehend it better. But if in any case you want me to discuss that explained part, then I will be making separate videos for them. So for example, today there is actually I'm from a remote area where newspaper the explained part is I don't know why this happens in the digital version of Indian Express. The explained part that comes in my newspaper that comes to my home is one day later, so that is received by me. So today an important part that has come in this explained part is about NCRB report, that is National Crime Record Bureau report, data that has been released. So we will be discussing that thing separately. So I will make separate video for it to highlight important points that are being explained in the part of that page. So let's start our discussion for today. So today is 24 October, so as you are aware, so we will be discussing the important articles. So this article we will not be discussing the power to impeach. So this is relating to the US president's impeachment that has been initiated in US Congress. So now this is very important article, that is shadow in the Kashmir, shadow in the mirror. So friends, this article is related to the Kashmir, the lockdown that India has imposed there in the wake of repeal of Article 370, which provided the special status to the state. So in this article, author basically makes a kind of analysis of a meeting that held few days ago in US. So it was basically US congressional hearing on human rights in South Asia. So the discussion was mainly on the situation in Kashmir. So US Congress met and there was a special meeting on the topic of human rights in South Asia. So as Kashmir is a contentious issue from since independence, so obviously Kashmir would have surely appeared in the discussion. So the author in this analyzes how that discussion viewed India's action to repeal the special status. So basically in this context, the author says that focus was not that much on whether the government's decision was valid or not, but the discussion was on the manner it was done. So basically the focus was the manner it was done. So obviously it would be hard to deny that the Kashmiri political leadership was detained and almost entire political class was arrested and other leaders were arrested. So lockdown was imposed. So hardly there was any representation of Kashmiris in an important decision that affected it. So it is a harsh fact. So but in this context, author says that basically this was the main topic of discussion. So the important senators asked the questions and raised the concerns that many, including Kashmiris, have done in India. So there has been a kind of, for example, questions over prolonged detentions of politicians, businessmen and others, and cutting off of the phone lines and blocking of access to the internet in the valley. So this is almost over now, 3 months have passed, and India has said that such actions were necessary to prevent any we can say cross-border terror activity from Pakistan. So the members that were present in this meeting, in this hearing, acknowledged Pakistan's reputation on this front, and they were appreciative of India's concern, but still they were unconvinced that these required the draconian measures that are now being implemented in the valley. So Assistant Secretary of Donald Trump for South Asia, who was the representative of Trump administration at the hearing, so she made an attempt to give an unbiased picture of India's actions and on the ground situation, but she was then constrained to say that this was a serious humanitarian crisis that was folding in the valley, because obviously entire communication lines are blocked, only now postpaid numbers are operating, and they have also been operated started operating from I think last week. So in this context, the government has not allowed leaders to visit the valley, and also then concern was made that US diplomats were not allowed to visit the Kashmir valley. So in this context, electoral exercise is also underway, that is today's 24 October, so local body elections are going to be held in Kashmir today at bloc levels, but then it is a known fact that every politician of the valley is behind bars or is under house arrest. Then who is conducting this political activity? So in this context, author says that the ruling part, it is basically also problematic, because other parties' leadership is arrested, and only the as the author has alleged that only the ruling party's party is allowed to carry out political activity in the state. So the author alleged that such kind of freedom was denied to all other players. So in this context, the author says that some are making a point that media management has not been taken effectively after the revocation of special status under Article 370. But then author says that no matter how much we take countermeasures or do effective management, and we can say prudent as well as skillful deft management, but then questions that are real, they will not go away, and no amount of media spin will be enough to make these questions go away. So in this context, the author concludes by saying that if the government wants that the situation must improve, then the people of the valley must be convinced without locking them up, and also it is not just to face the questions that the other countries or for that matter US is raising, but also it is in India's interest, because it will lead to more psychological integration rather than just territorial integration of Kashmir with India. So next is put away the stick. So this is very important article. This is also very important article. So this is about the two child norm that the Assam government is going to adopt. So far as the applicability of two government job or eligibility to the government jobs is concerned. So basically the thing is that Assam is proposing that those people who will have more than two children after January 2021, they will not be eligible for government jobs. So here author says that though this is not the first state, Assam is not the first state, already three states are there, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan, which have a two child norm norm in place for government jobs, and also at least five states are there where such norm is being followed for local body elections, for example panchayats, municipal corporations and zilla parishads. But then author says that there is also it is not just that simple establishing such or giving such guideline will control the population, increasing population. So author says that there is compelling evidence that measures such as debarring people from holding government office amounts to penalizing weaker sections of the society, including women, whose reproductive choices are often subject to a variety of constraints. So this is very important and notable point. So in this context, the thing is that it is not the poor are sometimes they are not that much aware, and also the issue is of less awareness and being less privileged. And also then another issue is of women empowerment, because if, say, for example, I will just give you a simple example. Say if a person, if two persons are married to each other, and if husband says that he wants a son, and if two girls have already the birth of two girls have already taken place, then he is convinced with this that he will go for the third child to check whether to try whether he will get the son or not. Then obviously in this context, if the woman is not that empowered or that educated, or it is not she is not that empowered to say to have a say in her reproductive choices, then certainly that would be a kind of punishment to the woman, because if she wants to go to opt for government job, then she will not be able to. So obviously the pressure of the family will be there, and in India you know that such thing can be said by the family, that we need a boy child and we don't need any government job. So then almost all surveys indicate that in this context that India's population growth rate has declined. So as of now it is 2.2% as per National Family Health Survey. So National Family Health Survey has found that total fertility rate is very close to the desired replacement level of 2.1%. And also then National Family Health Survey 4 data also confirms the views of various population experts that this population, the decline in population is dependent upon multiple factors. So women education has a direct bearing on fertility rates. So how this thing can have impact on the fertility rates? Obviously friends, if woman is educated, she will delay her marriage, she will look for career prospects, and then she will have say in reproductive rights, and then also she will be empowered to make other decisions. So in this context, women education has a direct bearing on fertility rates. So if we want to control the population, if we want to reduce the population, then such interventions must be made so that women must be empowered. So such type of things, that is restricting people from holding government office for they having more than two children, it is, according to the author, it is not workable. And then also it has also been observed that women who have, in this survey in fact it has been noted that women who have never been to school are likely to bear more than three children, while the fertility rate of those who have completed 12 years of schooling is 1.7. So then also India's population is still growing, but this fact is due to basically that India has a large proportion of population in the age group of 15 to 49. So obviously this is a reproductive age. So in absolute numbers, India's population is still growing, because it has so much number of people that are in reproductive age. So the issue is that already enough evidence is there, enough literature is there, that all these things, that is reducing the population, depends upon further slowing down the momentum, will require the raising age of marriage or delaying the first pregnancy and ensuring spacing between births. So all these things depend upon the woman empowerment. And also then issues of contraception. So non-availability of contraception is another issue, because 13% of the contraception need is not met. So over 30 million women of reproductive age are not able to access to contraception. So this is very important and concerning, especially so far as the poor households are concerned, in which men, especially who are alcoholic, because women, if they have such access to the contraception, then they can restrict the birth of one more child. But this hardly happens because women also do not have that to say, and then also they don't have wherewithal to buy such contraceptions, and also then accessibility is also less. So you can see that 30 million women of reproductive age are not able to access contraception. And also then in this context, author concludes that in dealing with such such problem, the investment is required in field of health, education, nutrition and employment avenues. Because if a person is employed, then that traditional attitude that more children will mean more working hands in the family, that will be solved if a person has secure job. And then if children get enough nutrition and women get enough nutrition, then also the child deaths can be prevented, because the more the child deaths, the more is the fertility rate, because people have this thing in mind that just having one or two children is not safe enough. So then investments in health would be needed in this context, and education will also be needed. So in this context, author concludes that government job or to right the right to contest elections are basically the citizens' rights. So state government must not deny such rights, and it must rethink its policy in so far as this guideline is concerned. So these two articles were very important. Now let's discuss the third article. The law isn't enough. So in this article in fact is also very important. So this is in context of mob lynchings, a spate of mob lynchings that have happened over last few years. So in this context, as I have said you friends earlier, that National Crime Records Bureau data was published so recently, but then data was also collected separately under the subheading of lynching and hate crimes. But then author says that it is the such data is absent, and this is kind of a kind of negligence, or we can say this is it has been basically it has been said while releasing the report that data is unreliable. So this is an issue of concern, because this leads to opaqueness. And also then figures that are available from different sources, it has been found that in 63 in such incidents, 28 persons have died, out of which 24 are Muslims. So also there have been 266 cases of lynching since 2014, and this continues to show an upward trend. It could cast an adverse impact about the role of the police in arresting such trends, as well as it could adversely affect the reputation of the ruling government. So then on June 17 night, the example is given of the Brij Ansari who was lynched. So this is an incident of 2019 after the general elections. So exactly a year before it, the mob attacked persons named Qasim Qureshi and Samiuddin, and they were brutally attacked in Hapur. So it resulted in the death of the former. So then all such things are have become more or less common. Here we will not be discussing about such incidents, the case studies, but then we will be discussing the general pattern. So the issue is that the role of police has also been questionable, because in all these incidents either the doctor has shown the negligence, and the policemen have shown the negligence, or they have deliberately kept themselves mute, and also some policemen have actively participated with the mob in such type of criminal acts. So police has played in fact a partisan role in most of such incidents, but then there are some exceptions also. So you can check the exception, you can read about them. Then hey, this is very important. The important part starts from here. So in this context, we must remember that in 2018 the Supreme Court directed the center and the state governments to ensure that stringent laws brought to deal with such incidents of lynching, so that this mob lynching can is made a separate offense and should be dealt with stringently. So then Manipur has passed such law, and then Rajasthan and West Bengal have passed such legislation more recently. But then issue is how will they be implemented on ground, because ultimately everything depends upon the political class and on the police, and police is influenced by the political class, and political class sometimes has shown the patronage to the fundamentalist elements which engage in such activities. So it would be difficult for policemen as well to deter such type of anti-social elements so that they don't repeat such incidents again, and they are punished stringently for their crime. So then again here the recommendations of the UP State Law Commission should be looked at, which stressed that there is need to take stringent action against officials who show dereliction of their duties. And then in this context the UP Law Commission has also recommended that the district magistrate and police officers can be imprisoned for a term extending up to 3 years with a fine of ₹5,000. So apart from monitoring fake news, other measures that the laws in the end author says that not just laws but then also other measures are needed, for example tackling the menace of fake news, especially in today's world of social media and internet, so that the police can promptly arrest those persons who spread and share and originate this such kind of fake information. And then also author says that the police must also spread its intelligence dragnet, so that any such incident, if it is being planned, then it is reported to the control room within the minutes, and such incidents could be prevented. So districts that are that have historically remained criminally sensitive, they must have special teams and special personnel, armed personnel who must be well equipped, so that they can rush to any spot within minutes to handle such type of incidents or such to handle frenzied mob. So then prompt investigations must also happen, followed by the arrest and trial by fast track should be happened, so that there is a deterrence of law, and also there must be every effort be made so that the victims and witnesses, if an effort is made to influence them, then that can be prevented. So in this context author says that it would be good if in such circumstances, if the police has the power to protect the witnesses and victims, and also it is important that lynching must be made a non-bailable offense, so that the culprits don't pressurize the victims or the witness victim or witness after getting the bail. So in this context author not just says that police must do its duty promptly, but also it has said that if any policeman who has watched the entire incident as a mute spectator, he or she must also be tried in the same manner as the culprits. So then senior police officers must also be taken to task if found guilty of dereliction of duty. So this is about your mob lynching. So you can if any question appears in the newspaper in your exam, then you can use important points from this article. So before moving on to the next article, let me tell you friends that read for improving yourself, not just read for exam, because ultimately exam everybody reads for the examination. Everybody tries to gather as many points as he or she can, but what will make you different is your intellectual development. Because if you are not considering, or if you are not giving thoughts to the things that are happening around you, then that the reading will not just suffice, because this every person can do reading or cramming some facts is okay, it is good, but then ultimately the test is of your intellect. So you must succeed in this test of your intellect. So now let's move to the next article. Next is icon on the island. We will not be discussing this article. This is in the context of elections in the Sri Lanka. So this article is not important, and this article, that is defenders need defending. Though this article is not important, and also we will not be discussing this article, but you can read this article. This can give you certain viewpoints and also certain perception that how CBI works, and whether CBI works in pressure or and how transparent is the entire process, whether in judiciary or different police institutions that are there in the country. And then this article is very important, that is development lessons from Gandhi. So this article is in the context of 150th birth anniversary of Bapu, that fell on 2nd October. So there have been multiple articles that have been published in Indian Express this month, and also they touched upon the different themes on and different themes on which the Gandhi held view. But then in this article, the author talks about the conception of how we can learn from Mahatma Gandhi for sustainable development. So here the author talks about that sustainable development goal has today become a buzzword. So in this context, author says that but then we must remember that in 1908 itself, Gandhiji had said that that the threat to the common future of humanity is basically a relentless quest for material goods and services. So obviously, sustainable development can only take place if we do sustainable consumption. Because if we are not restraining our consumption, then certainly we will be exploiting our natural resources to the maximum extent, and that development is certainly not sustainable development, because it not only pollutes our environment and deplete our natural resources, but also threatens the life of coming generations. And then in this context, author says that though these 17 sustainable development goals were released in 2015, in this context, author says that 12th sustainable development goal has specifically this text in it, that is ensure sustainable development and production patterns. So author says if Sindh Swaraj philosophy of Mahatma Gandhi is if Sindh Swaraj of Mahatma Gandhi is to be read, then one can see that there is a clear link between sustainable development goals and they basically mirror the philosophy enunciated in Sindh Swaraj. So how these will then that will make an impact? Obviously, if all the persons over this planet, they engage in a responsible consumption, then obviously that much of exploitation of natural resources will not happen. And also other thing is that the Gandhiji wanted to highlight that one should respect the indigenous people, indigenous knowledge, native people and their culture. So in this context, the idea of obviously if there is more consumption, then certainly this is not in the interest of native population and indigenous knowledge. And obviously if consumption increases and it increases without any restraint, then it will it is basically a cause and consequence of greed, in which the interests of the indigenous people and cultures will be compromised. So in this context, Gandhiji also used to say that India lives in its villages. So any development strategy that must be adopted by India, it must begins with villages. So it is needless to say, obviously, then in this context, that Gandhiji's ideas are particularly very relevant so far as country's whole development is concerned, because Gandhiji knew that the repository of a country's resources are basically villages and the indigenous population. So if certainly technological advancement and changing aspirations can bring about changes in how we achieve our goals, but basic principles must guide us. And both Gandhiji and a person who was a very devout follower of Gandhiji, that is Nanaji, so he also held that unnecessary consumption should not happen. So in this context, harmonious unnecessary consumption doesn't mean harmonious growth, because harmonious growth can be achieved by employing cultural practices. So it is important that native people are given importance, and their importance and their wisdom must be appreciated. So then other thing is that there must in simple words, the focus is on sustainable consumption. So many times author says that Mahatma Gandhi used to criticize Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, who was the first Prime Minister of India, that he was wasting resources, precious natural resources, for his comfort. So then in this context, the thing is entire that other thing that important theme that the article highlights is that every region in India has unique social and geographical characteristics. If we assume at broad level, then there are 127 agroclimatic zones in India. So then obviously it shows that on one policy cannot work for whole of India. So each region has distinctive social and geographical characteristics, and in fact if we go into each agroclimatic zone and then we check at the level of diversity, at the level of ground, the diversities, then there are scores of eco-climatic zones in each such zone. So in this context, Gandhiji, the author highlights that the national strategy, a single national strategy, cannot be of no value unless and until the local people are not involved in the development of the country. So in this context, he had underlined the decentralized system of economics and development. So in today's India or in today's world, we are more and more focusing upon decentralization of powers, more authority to local bodies, more representation at local levels, more decision making powers. So this thing Mahatma Gandhi had underlined in the 20th century itself. In this context, the thing is that there must be focus on decentralized system of economics and development, so that local needs and local aspirations and local knowledge, are factored in while formulating any such plans on the basis of statistical information. So sustainable development, if author says, is not is useless if we don't understand the meaning of sustainable consumption, because the sustainable consumption is basically the means of achieving sustainable development. So unless we practice restraint, obviously we cannot avoid exploitation of natural resources. So thus he in the end he said that only thing that the development sustainable can happen is through limited exploitation, and limited exploitation can only happen through if there is limited consumption. So all these things form the subtext of SDG 12. So what is the broad overview of this article? The broad overview is sustainable consumption leads to sustainable development, and sustainable consumption was the principle that was enunciated by Mahatma Gandhi. So obviously if we are talking in 21st century about the sustainable development, then certainly we owe a lot of ideas to Mahatma Gandhi. So this is all about, friends, today's discussion about Indian Express important articles. So we have discussed nearly 4 or 5 articles. So if there is anything remaining, that is the explained page of Indian Express. So we will be coming with a separate video within two three hours for it. So stay tuned. If you like this video, then do ensure to like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice day ahead.